How about you?
I'm all right. Nice day. Yeah. He's doing a little story, a spot love story.
Okay.
Independent journalist.
Oh, there you go. That's all you had to say. I'm a journalist.
Well, I didn't really have to say. I don't really have to talk to you.
Well, you don't have to talk to me. No, I can ask you anything I want to.
Well, I know, but just the way you said right there.
I can ask you anything I want, right?
Okay, calm down. I didn't say you couldn't ask me anything.
Well, don't tell me to calm down. I'm fine.
I'll tell you to calm down.
The reason he can't tell you to calm down is because you got tattoos on your arm. And you work for law enforcement. That's why he can't tell you nothing. Since you are the law enforcement, you are entitled to tell that journalist everything he wants to know. And I'm sorry that you're too stupid to know that, because your leaders that lead you to do what you're doing must be stupid as hell too. They must don't know the constitutional rights. So far as I'm concerned, looking at you with tattoos all over your arm, I wouldn't have you as a law enforcement, because that is a grace and a sin, and it's not a gentleman look towards the teenagers coming up on this planet.
Come on, I forgot your speech.
Right. Yeah, and so do I. So I'll stay here. You guys can stay here as long as you want.
You confronted us, bro. I didn't confront you.
Yeah.
So what's the reason for confronting? Am I doing something illegal?
I can ask you anything I want, right?
You
I
know,
got the same
right. But you know that just being what you are, you know that we know where we're at, so.
You do?
Are you an officer of the law? What's your name and badge number, for the record?
I don't have to tell you that either.
So you
see, there's a lot of attitude there. If he is with the law enforcement, I don't have to tell you nothing. Well, that's the kind of laws you do not need. Not for the new generation coming up. Because the law enforcement has already fucked up the old generation. When the new generation comes, we don't need those kind of people that you're looking at right there. Not on this earth.
You're telling me that your policy states that you don't have to when a citizen asks you.
Correct.
So then you need to leave us alone and stop bothering us.
Says you.
I'm just telling you.
You're just telling me?
Yeah, leave me and my daughter alone.
So you can tell me whatever you want, but I can't.
If you approach me like that, yeah, and I don't want to talk to you.
Approach you like what? I got mail in my hand and a water bottle.
Okay, man. And I work with other people, bro, but you know.
Well, you're the one that approached up and walked towards him. You're the one that stopped there. Why didn't you just keep on walking if you can do what you want to? You didn't have to stop where that journalist was. But looking at you in the video, your intention was to stop right where you stopped.
I ain't a criminal, so you can just...
Who said you were a criminal?
The way you're approaching me.
That's what you guys are doing.
I told you. And then
I don't go to your office videotaping your building.
Do I pay you or do you pay me?
You don't pay me.
Are you sure about that?
Yeah, I'm
no tax money. You don't receive
I'm
no tax money.
I'm 100% sure I don't get any.
You're not a public officer.
Well, dude, we can debate this all day long, but I can tell.
Well, he asked you a simple question. Can't you answer a simple question? If you work for the law enforcement, citizens, taxpayers pay you. If you do not work for the law enforcement, then you're breaking the law. And we'll see what else you got to say.
This, you don't pay my salary.
I can tell you this, I don't give a shit what you think.
So apparently U.S. Marshals.
Yeah, U.S. Marshal, so
now you want to cuss at me? I'm not cussing at you, man, and nobody's being disrespectful. All I did was ask
by you coming out here and staying that you can stay here, and by your presence, of you being a marshal, you think that works on most people, but you know what?
It isn't intimidating you.
Whatever, bro. You play your little game, we know.
Nobody's playing the game. You're the only one doing games.
To go back.
No. You're the one that walked up to him and stopped. You can't remember that, my friend. Watch the video. You're the one that walked up and stopped in front of his face. So it looks like me, you're the one playing the game. Let's carry on.
Because I go do what you get paid for. What are you bothering us for? I can tell you whatever I want. You just told me that we could say whatever we want, right?
Right.
So you're being a hypocrite now on camera. You just told me that you could say whatever you want, and right now you told me I can't say it.
Right. Nobody's being a hypocrite.
I don't have to listen to you. You're not my dad, bro. Bye.
Okay. Bye.
Bye.
Nobody told you to leave. I didn't tell you to leave either.
But you don't need to be around me. I'm not bothering you, dude.
Right.
All right, so.
I get this.
You're right, because he come up to bother you. That's actually what he did. Because with them tattoos makes him a powerful man. With a bald head and all them tattoos, that is a disgrace for the younger generation to come up and look at shit like that.
Sidewalk just like you guys do.
Yeah, but you know what your tactics are, bro. We know what your tactics are, bro. Come on.
You guys are a little bit of a waste of time.
You're the one wasting time, bro. You're on the clock, aren't you?
I'm not wasting time, that's for sure.
Well, then you should mind your own business and go do what you gotta do.